Hi there, my name is Sean Jordison, and this is going to be a video walkthrough for Canvas accessibility. The goal of this video is to walk you through the most commonly found accessibility elements that may exist on your pages. So I have a sample page here that has many accessibility errors in it, and what we're going to do is simply walk through them and fix them. So to begin, let's select the Edit button. I like to design my accessibility starting from the very top of the page, going all the way down. I also like to start my content below a H2. So I'm gonna add in some text here that's called overview. I'm gonna select this text, use the drop down arrow to make this a header too. Now from here, this paragraph looks fine. There's no accessibility elements to address. I do have another area here that says, where do I begin designing? This is also a paragraph. So what I'm going to do is make this content a heading 2, but we also want to turn off bolding, and I actually want it to be lowercase. So I'm just gonna retype that and delete this text out. The reason we want it to be lowercase is because screen readers will often read acronyms letter by letter. And when it sees all capital letters, it could sometimes interpret that word to be an acronym. Next up, we have a couple dashes here. These should be built-in bulleted list because the order is not important. So I'm going to select these two items and select bullet list from the rich content editor. I'm going to come back through here and delete the dashes out and move on to my next heading. The next heading is there enough time for my students? First, I want to retype it to make sure we get rid of all that capitalization. Next, I want to remove the bolding on this text. So I'm going to select the text and select bold. I'm going to make this text a header 3 as it relates to this heading 2 of where do I begin designing. And so let's keep going here. Looks like we have a little bit of misspellings. Is there enough time? This is a part of this header down here. So this is also going to be a heading 3. I'm then going to remove the bolding. And then under design and develop, I'm also going to remove bolding, and it's actually already marked as a header 4, which is perfect. So let's keep going. It looks like this was supposed to be a couple list items that we tried to designate with X's. But let's make this an actual bulleted list. We can come back through, delete the text. And then we have a new area that doesn't really relate to any of our current heading structures. So I'm gonna select the text and make it a heading 2. Now from here, we have a built-in list. And if you're not used to doing this, these list items might look correct. They are numbers. They clearly are meant to be in a list. But here's the deal. It's not actually a list within the structure of the HTML. So we need to select all of our text and then select numbered list. And it puts in an actual list, which we must come in here and actually remove these extra numbers. And we can keep going. So the essay writing process, this looks like it should be a heading. We're gonna go ahead and make that a heading 2. And then again, we have another list that should be a bulleted, this should be a numbered list as it represents a sequence of steps. All right, next up we have a link. So here's the Canvas guide for viewing my feedback in the gradebook. So first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to copy the hyperlink, with Control C, and I'm going to select feedback in the gradebook. Then select link to URL and paste our link with Control V. Then we're going to select insert link, which now puts the link on these words. So I can end this with a period and delete the rest of this content. So using the delete key on my keyboard, I'm removing this extra text, as we do not want extra hyperlinks or full URLs on the page. Additionally, we want to avoid vague language like the words here. So we need to fix these two links. First, let's take a look at the sentence. Read about the role and structure of U.S. courts and U.S. Supreme Court procedures here and here. So I'm going to add the word procedures. And to get this link out, I'm going to select in the link with my mouse. I'm going to select the link to URL button. And from here, I'm going to copy the link out. So I just did a Control C. Now I'm going to select my text where I want to put the link, select the link to URL button, Control V to paste, and select insert link. Now we have one more to fix. I'm going to put my cursor in this link, select link to URL. I'm going to simply copy the link out, close the window, and add my link to this text on the page by selecting the text, select link to URL, paste, and then insert link. Now I can delete all of this extra text out. And we have another link, but the sentence doesn't really support it. So we're going to say additional resources about language and culture. I'm going to select in this link, select the link to URL button to copy my link out, Control C to copy this out. And then I'm going to paste it on my newly created text and then select insert link. Now I could delete this extra text out. All right, let's see what else we have in this area. So we have a table that we'll need to address. I'm going to leave the table and we're going to use the check accessibility tool to fix this table. With our image though, let's select the image, select embed image, and this is where we can add alternate text and select update. We have another table here. I'm also going to use the check accessibility tool. So let's go ahead and run that. We're going to run the check accessibility tool. Adjacent links with the same URL should be a single link. Okay, that looks like an actual error that can be fixed. So we'll select apply. We need to add a caption. Whoops. I apparently cannot type today. Oh my goodness. All right, we're going to put sample data, and then let's select header row for our headers, select apply. And we have one more sample data for a caption and select apply. Now what's interesting, it didn't catch these all caps. So I'm going to come in here and fix these. And it's a good reminder that the accessibility checker is automated and it doesn't catch every error. And all capitalization should be avoided if possible, unless you are working with an acronym. Let's go ahead and run that check accessibility tool once more. Perfect. No issues were found. Select save. We can quickly review, and this page looks a lot better. We have clean links. We have clear tables. We have an image with alternate text, and this page is fully accessible. So you just learned how to make a Canvas page accessible. I hope this video walkthrough was useful for you. Thank you for watching.